सब्सक्राइब कीजिए नेहरा क्लासेस यूट्यूब चैनल को और बेल आइकन को दबाइए हमारे लेटेस्ट वीडियोस के नोटिफिकेशंस पाने के लिए।
हाय गाइस, वंस अगेन वेलकम बैक टू अवर नेहरा क्लासेस यूट्यूब चैनल एंड दिस इज योर फ्रेंड विकास नेहरा हेयर। फ्रेंड्स, इन टुडेज ट्यूटोरियल आई शैल गाइड यू विद द इंस्टॉलेशन एंड कॉन्फ़िगरेशन ऑफ केवीएम इन रेड हैट एंटरप्राइज लिनक्स 7 और सेंटोएस 7। बट बिफोर दैट लेट मी गिव यू द ब्रीफ idea about KVM. KVM stands for Kernel-based Virtual Machine. It is a virtualization technology which is used in Linux-based systems, especially in Red Hat. KVM is a full virtualization solution for Linux hardware containing virtualization extensions for Intel VT or AMD-V. It consists of a loadable kernel module that is kvm.ko, and it provides core virtualization infrastructure and processor specific module kvm-intel.ko for the Intel CPU and kvm.amd for AMD processors. And using KVM, one can run multiple virtual machines running unmodified Linux or Windows images, and each virtual machine has private virtualized hardware, that is a network card, graphics, disk, adapter, etc. And it is an open source software, and the kernel component of KVM is included in the mainline Linux as of 2.6.20. means after this kernel 2.6.20 we can use this feature. And how does it work? KVM actually converts Linux into type 1 hypervisor, and all hypervisors need some operating system level components such as memory management, process scheduler, input output stack, device drivers, security manager, and network card, graphic adapter, CPU, memory, and disks. Now, let's proceed towards the installation of KVM in CentOS 7. So, in today's tutorial, I will also guide you before the installation that what are the requirements of KVM in our machine. So, if you will open the virtualization software like VMware and go to the settings of the server in which you want to install this KVM feature. So for that, if you click on the processors here, to use the KVM you must tick the checkbox that is virtualize Intel VT, EPT or AMD-V. So you have to enable this option. So click here, and keep in mind that you should use at least two number of processors here, because if we are going to install a virtual machine inside this virtual server, that will require at least one processor. So how much processors do you need here, that depends on how much virtual machines you want to run inside this server. Then click OK and power on the virtual machine or your server. After this, I will show you step by step how can you install and configure KVM. But before that, let me tell you, you should log in the machine as the root user, and the local YUM repository should be properly configured in your machine. If you are not able to configure it, you can watch my videos. I will provide you the link of those videos in the description and in the I button as well. So you can see I have already configured the local YUM repository in my server, from where we will install the required packages. And you can see that I am using CentOS 7 and the kernel version is 3.10. And if I talk about the release, so I am using CentOS Linux release 7.4.1708. Now if I show you the details of LSBLK, I have an additional disk on which I have created a partition and created a volume group which I have mounted on /kvm directory which I have created already in my machine, and in this directory we will keep the kernel based virtual machine images, means we will use this for the virtualization. Now if I show you the details of mount points, we have formatted it in ext4 type file system and size is 15 GB. So for permanent mounting, let me make an entry in the fstep file so that it can withstand the server rebooting. So let me make an entry for this. Yes, now we are good to go. Now our first step will be to set the SE Linux as permissive. So if you see the details of get enforce, if you see the details of the SE Linux with the get enforce command, you will see that it is now permissive. We have to ensure that the necessary virtualization configurations are already set in our machine. So we can run this command graph-e svm vmx proc cpu info, and if you will get this kind of output, it means you are good to go. It should display this vmx in the output. Now we need to install the kvm packages in our server, and for that we need to run this command yum install -y qemu-kvm libvirt python libguest fs tools and vit-install. Press enter. So these packages will be installed in your machine along with the dependencies, and it can take some time depending upon the capacity of your system. So we have successfully installed all the required packages in our server. Now we need to start the libvirt daemon service and check the status of the same. The service is up and running. It means we are good to go. In the next step, let me show you the output of ifconfig command, which will display the network adapters and IP addresses. So here I have two adapter configurations, and this is 192.168.1.140, which is my local network IP address. I am using Wi-Fi here for the internet connection, and this is the virtual adapter whose IP address is 192.168.122.1. Now we need to edit this ENS033 adapter, ENS33, and here we need to comment some lines. So here you need to comment IP address, netmask and gateway. So we will comment these lines. Go in the insert mode, comment IP address, gateway and netmask. And we need to mention this bridge is equal to virbr0 in this file. So at the last line, just mention this and save the changes. We are enabling the virtual adapter, so we are making these changes. Now we need to run this command, which will copy the file in the virtual adapter. So we are running cp-p etc6 config network scripts ifcfg, and the name of this file is ENS33, and we are copying it here etc sysconfig network script with the name as virbr0. Press enter. So we have copied it. Now open it in VI editor and make the required changes in this file. Here we need to enable these IP address net mask gateway, and here we need to mention the name as device is equal to virbr0. So uncomment these lines, go in the insert mode, uncomment IP address net mask and the gateway, and instead of this bridge mention here device. So remove this and mention here device. And in the type, just mention bridge instead of Ethernet. Save the changes. Now in the next step, we need to long list this file that is inside usrlib sysctl.d. The name of the file is 60-libvidd.conf. Now if you run the rpm qf command, it should show the details of this. Now open this file in the VI editor, and here you need to add this line, that is to enable the IP address version 4, that is net.ipv4.ip_forward=1, and save the changes. After this, run this command sbin sysctl.w, and again check it with sbin sysctl -p command, and now it should show you the changes which we have made in that particular file. Now I will list the details of virtual adapter, that is virbr0, with the ifconfig command, and it is showing the IP address of our system. Now we can set the DHCP range for the virtual server with virsh net -edit default command, and here we can make the required changes. So my network connection is starting from 192.168.1, and I want to use the IP range from 200 to 254, and the IP address of this machine is 140. Now save the changes. And again added this file, that is etc sysconfig network scripts route -virbr0. So here make an entry for this 192.168 for your network with subnet mask and via the IP address of your machine, and mention the virtual adapter. Save the changes. Now in the next step, we need to reboot our machine. I'm going to reboot it. So you can use all these commands step by step, so do not worry about the commands. I will provide you each and every command in the description of this video. Let the machine start up. It can take some time. So we have successfully rebooted our machine. Now once again check the details of the mount points. Yes, KVM is there, and we will verify the process. We will check the status of live with the daemon. It is up and running, so no issues. We can proceed. Now if I list the output of ifconfig command, ifconfig-a, it will show the IP address of our virtual adapter. It means we are good to go. Now copy the CentOS 7 ISO image in the TMP directory of your server, and you can use the shared folder option in the VMware for that. So I have already copied it in the TMP directory. So after that, in the next step, let me list this. So you can see the details of the ISO image. Now modify the permissions using chmod command. Chmod 775, make it executable. Again run the same command to see the permissions. Now it is executable. After that, you can run the OS info query command, which will list the details of the supported KVMs which can you install on it. So there are a lot of OS: Fedora, FreeBSD, Magnia, Mkdre, NetBSD, OpenSUSE, RHEL, Ubuntu, Windows. So we need to install the CentOS. So we can grep the CentOS by using grep command. So these are the versions of CentOS which we can install on this server. So I want to install CentOS 7. So I can use this one. Now in the next step, let me show you the details of the mount points of my server. Here if I run the df-h command, you will see this KVM directory which I have created and mounted over the SDB. So we will use it for our KVM. Let me show you the details of this. There is no file or directory inside this KVM directory. Now we are going to install the KVM from this virt-install command. So this virt-install command will create a KVM in our CentOS 7. So let me copy it and paste it here. So this command will create the KVM, and after that the installation of CentOS 7 will start in that KVM. So I'm going to use this KVM whose name will be kvm-mac. We can mention the description for the same with the option --- description. We can specify the OS type, that is Linux. We can specify the variant type, that is CentOS 7.0. After that, we can specify the size of the RAM, that is 1 GB or 1024 MB, and number of CPUs we can specify after that. And thereafter, we can specify the path where this image of KVM will be created in the server. So I'm creating it inside the KVM directory which I have created. After that, we can specify the size of the same, and we can specify whether we need the GUI or not, and the other console details, and the location from this installation will start. So that will be started with the help of this ISO image which I have copied inside the TMP directory. Now press enter. So this command will create a KVM in my server, and after that the installation of CentOS 7 will begin in it. So it can take some time. Yes, you can see that the system has been created, KVM has been created, and the installation is going to be happen. services are being loaded on the RAM, and after this it will start the installer. The installation can take some time and it is totally CLI based installation. So here you need to specify each and everything with CLI. Let me show you. Let the installer start up. So here you can see that the installer has been started, and now it will prompt us for the different options which are required at the time of the installation. Now it will ask us for the time zone, the language selection, the disk partitioning, the root account password, and all those details. You can see it here. So let me provide it all these details and install the server. So I'm going to pause the video for this time while I provide all these details, otherwise this video will become very long, and I will continue once the installation will be done, and I'll show you how can we go in the console and how can we see all those details of the KVM. So I'm going to pause it. You can try it at your own. So I have provided it all the required parameters. Now in order to begin the installation, we need to type or press B letter on the keyboard and press enter. So it will start installing the CentOS 7. So here you can see that the installation is happening and it is creating all the required files for the installation. And I'm going to pause the video again and I will show you once the installation is done. Now you can see that the installation has been completed. Now if you will press enter, it will quit. Yes. So we have successfully created the kernel based virtual machine in our server and we have installed the CentOS 7.0 in that. So here you can see that we are going to start the KVM. Press enter. So it will turn it on. Now we have several commands which we use to manage the KVM. You can see that the KVM is booting up just like a normal server. So it is asking for the credentials now. So I can provide the root username here and the password of the root account. So you can see I have logged in the machine, in the KVM machine which I have created in the CentOS 7 server. Uname-a, it will work in just similar to physical server or the virtual server. There is no change in it. So if you want to go out of this KVM, you need to press Ctrl Shift and 5 on your keyboard. But before that, let me show you the IP address of my KVM. You can see that it is taking the IP address of 192.168.1.102. That is from the DHCP server, since I have mentioned DHCP at the time of installation. And this is my original CentOS server, the host CentOS server, and the IP address of it is 192.168.1.140. So this is the KVM which is running on this host, that is CentOS 7. Now if I need to manage the KVM, there are several commands. So if you want to list all the KVMs running on the host, you can run this vir sh list --all. So you can see that there are two KVM running in my machine, and this is the recent one which I have created, that is kvmac. If you want to list the details of the domain, So for that you can run virsh dom info command, and after that you can specify the ID of the KVM or the name of the KVM. So it will show you the details of the KVM, like the name, UUID, OS type, its status, CPU, memory, SE Linux, all those details. If you want to turn it off, you can run virsh shutdown command, virsh shutdown and kvmac. So it will turn this off. So you can see that we got a message, domain kv is being shut down. So if you will go on the terminal of kvm, you will see that it is going to be turned off. Now if you will again run the list command, here you will see that this kvmac is now showing as shut off. So we have turned it off. In case you want to start it again, you can run virsh start command and mention the name or the ID. Press enter. So it will start the KVM. If you want to use the console, means if you want to go inside the KVM and want to do something there, so for that you can run virsh console and after that mention the name, that is kvmac in my case. So we have logged in. Now it is asking for the credentials. Mention the username and the password here, and we are inside the console of our KVM. In case you want to clone it, so for that you first need to turn it off. So inside the console you can mention the init 0 or shutdown command, so it will turn it off. Now we need to, if we want to clone it, we can run wilt-clone command, and this command will create another machine with a different name. So the command is wilt-clone --connect QEMU system--original. After that you have to mention the name of the KVM which you want to clone, and after that you need to specify the name of the new KVM. So I am going to use the name as kvmac2 and the path of the image. Press enter. So this command will clone this, and you can see that it is going to clone it, and it can take some time depending upon the capacity. I'm going to pause the video again. So you can see that we have successfully cloned it, and we have created another KVM with the name as kvmac2, and we can list the details with virlist command. So here you can see that we have cloned this kvmac, and the name of the new clone is kvmac2. So if you want to turn it on, you can use virsh start command kvmac2. So it will turn it on. You can see that the kvmac2 has been started, and if you want to use the console, we can run the console command for that, virsh console kvmac2. So this command will help us to use the console of kvmac2 which we have just cloned. So you can see that the machine is booting up, and now it will prompt us for the username and the password. Yes. So you can see that I have successfully logged in the virtual machine which we have just cloned. This is the name of the virtual machine or the KVM, and this is our host on which we have created these KVMs. So guys, in this way we can create kernel based virtual machines in RHEL 7 or CentOS 7. Hope you guys would have enjoyed this video and you will like it, and this video would become very beneficial for you guys. If you like it, then do share it with your friends, and if you are new on our channel, then do not forget to press the subscribe button and turn on the bell notification. I will see you guys in any other session. Till then, bye bye. Jai Hind, Vande Mataram.